Welcome to Radio Frequency and Microwave Laboratory. This is Prashant from RGKT Basar. In this video, we discuss about list of the experiments which are going to be performed in the laboratory. These list of the experiments are divided into two sections, Section A and Section B. In Section A, these are the experiments list. Section A starts with study experiment, that is standing wave pattern.
Transmission line or a waveguide is not terminated with proper natural direction, there will be reflections occur. The incident and reflected wave results in standing wave pattern. In this experiment, we can observe wave patterns for different loads like open circuit, short circuit, pure capacitive, or pure inductive loads. The next experiment is measurement of guide wavelength and frequency. When a microwave source is generated a signal, that means it consists of power, frequency, and wavelength.
We are going to find out frequency and wavelength by using two methods, that is direct method. First method, by tuning frequency meter, we are going to find frequency of the signal. By using this method, we are not able to find out wavelength. Due to this reason, we shift to the second method, that is throttle line method. By using tunable probe and throttle line section, we are going to find locations of minimas or locations of maximas in terms of centimeters. By substituting these values into formula, we get frequency and wavelength.
And next experiment is repeller mode characteristics of reflex klystron. Due to velocity modulation, klystron exhibits modes of operations. This experiment reveals the relationship in between power to the frequency and power to the repeller voltage. Next experiment is IV characteristics of gun diode. In this experiment, by varying bias voltage, we are going to find out relationship in between current and voltages of gun. Here we can observe peak and values in the region of negative resistance region. Next experiment is measurement of VSWR, voltage standing wave ratio. This is extension of first experiment. There we discuss about how they are formed, but here we discuss about how to find the value of S. If that value of S is less than 10, we use slaughter line method to find out VSWR. If S value is greater than 10, we are going to use double minima method for finding VSWR. And next experiment is calibration of crystal detector. In generally, crystal detector acts as a square law device and it works as low pass filter. Here we are going to prove that current I is proportional to V power gamma, where gamma is approximately 2. Next two experiments are based on attenuators, that is measurement of attenuator and calibration of attenuator. These are fixed type attenuation and variable type attenuation. An attenuator is used to reduce the power of the signal without changing appearance of waveform or its shape. Coming to the fixed attenuator, output-input relationship in terms of fixed values like 3 dB, 6 dB, 10 dB and so on. While coming to the variable attenuation, We can set or fix required attenuations like 1.9 dB, 3.2 dB, 5.7 dB and so on. Next experiment is measurement of unknown impedance. By taking any component which is available in our lab is connected to the load end of your test bench and finding impedance for that component is known as unknown impedance. To find impedance, we have two possible ways. One is by using load impedance formula and second one is by using Smith chart. Next experiment is radiation pattern of horn antenna and parabolic dish antenna. This is the last experiment in section A. In previous experiments, we transmitted signal through closed waveguide, that is source to the destination. But in this experiment, TX and RX are separated with some distance d and air as a dielectric or transmission medium. When these transmitter and receiver are line of sight, the maximum power is transmitted to the receiver. That is, the power intensity is maximum in main lobe and minimum at side lobe. By using these values, we are going to draw radiation pattern of horn antenna as well as radiation pattern of parabolic dish antenna. Section B. Section B divided into two parts. One is resonant microwave components and second one is non-resonant microwave components. In resonant microwave components, we start with study experiment, that is introduction regarding S parameters. Here we can learn what is an S parameter, how to represent it and how to find the values of S. Next experiment is characteristics of magic tee with the help of S matrix and observe the phase difference with the help of CRO. Magic tee consists of HR and ER with four ports. In this experiment, fade is applied to one of the ports and output is observed at all other ports. To get S matrix, we can observe when the power is fed to port 4, it is divided into equally two parts, port 2 and port 1, with out of phase. That phase difference is observed by using CRO. Next experiment is directional coupler. Directional coupler consists of two transmission lines. One is main line and second one is auxiliary line. These two lines are electromagnetically coupled. In generally, directional coupler mainly used to find power measurement of incident wave, reflected wave, which are transmitted through waveguide. And we are going to calculate directivity, isolation, and how much insertion loss we are getting, and what is coupling factor, and how to represent in S matrix, values of S matrix. And we are going to prove that P square plus Q square equal to 1. In section B, another part is non-resonant microwave component. Here, we have a first experiment, circulator. Circulator is a three-port network or multi-port. In this lab, we have T-junction and Y-junction three-port circulators. If we fed power into one of the port, then that power is absorbed in the next port in a circular direction and other ports are isolated with input port. For the circulator, we are going to find out S matrix and VSWR. Next experiment is four port circulator by using two magic tees and one gyrator. In previous part, we already discussed about magic tee. By using that knowledge, here we are going to implement four port circulator. And last experiment in this laboratory is isolator, by using Y circulator or by using T junction circulator. An isolator is a two port unidirectional component. When coming to the circulator, which consists of three ports, from the three ports, one of the port is matched with load and other two remaining utilized as input and output. In this way, we are going to implement isolator. Thank you.